Hi everybody, welcome to my dog vlog. This week is about tips to help your dog keep calm during thunder and lightning storms. Now, as we all know, apart from maybe the very, very lucky people, dogs hate thunder and lightning. Obviously they get very panicky, they get scared and they hide, and it's just very horrible for everybody involved. Now, behaviourists don't know why exactly this happens even. They say that dogs might be reacting to the sound of the thunder, the wind, the rain, or possibly lightning flashes. But they also say that dogs can, because sometimes dogs start reacting before the thunder and lightning's actually started, and this can be because they've detected a drop in pressure. So it's very interesting, but they're not sure why. Okay, well, tip one is similar to when there's fireworks, and that's to create a safe place for your dog to hide during a thunder and lightning storm. So wherever your dog, when it's fearful, wherever it's heading to, make sure you allow the dog to go in there. So if the dog wants to go and so it feels safe in your bedroom, then make a little hidey hole in the bedroom, and make sure that the flashes of lightning can't be seen from the hidey hole as well. That will definitely help. Okay, tip number two is distraction. Now, try and distract your dog with their favourite toy or their favourite game or their favourite food, whatever it is, try and get them involved in playing with you, basically. So this is best to be done also before the dog is showing majorly fearful signs. So when the dog is just kind of picking up on the fact that there might be a storm, then this is a good time to try and distract your dog. And it won't solve it, but it could possibly delay the worst reaction. I'd hopefully cut it a little bit shorter so everyone's a little less tense for a little less time. Number three, compete with the noise. So as we know, we've told you before, play relaxmydog music or put a fan on or put the radio on so there's people speaking, and make sure you compete and try and beat the noise of the thunder and lightning, and this will definitely make your dog feel more comfortable so that they can't just hear this horrible crashing and banging from outside. Okay, now if you wanted to look at helping your dog permanently in terms of curing the fear of thunder and lightning, because a lot of dogs have it a lot worse than others and can actually chew things and become quite distressed, then it's definitely a very good idea to speak to your vet, because there are possible ways where you basically desensitise your dog to a thunder and lightning storm. And ways to do that are to play, for example, on a CD, the sounds of a thunder and lightning storm, but very quietly to start off with, or to play sounds of wind and rain, like strong wind and rain, but also start off quietly and then slowly increasing this noise so that your dog becomes less sensitive to it and less shocked by it when it actually happens. But make sure you speak to your vet, because obviously if people try this after they've seen this video, they can ultimately scare their dog even more by putting the wrong volume on to start off with in terms of the storm noise, and it can really, really upset your dog. So in order not to do that, make sure you speak to your vet first. But that's all for this week. The next dog vlog will be in 2 weeks' time, as we're going to do them fortnightly from now on. And just make sure you subscribe on YouTube, follow us on Twitter, and like us on Facebook. And we would really appreciate any comments left below. Okay, thank you very much, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye, guys.